Hi my dear students, welcome to Maths online class. We are discussing with the chapter fractions. In the previous video we discussed about fractions, type of fractions and comparison of fraction. Today we are going to look how can we add given fractions. What changes comes in the case of numerator and denominator and how can we add fractions. We'll deal all these things with some examples. Now we'll discuss some examples on addition of fractions. Here is the first question. 3 by 7 plus 2 by 7. By looking at this fraction, what you can understand? What type of fraction is this? You have studied two type of fractions. What are they? Like fractions and unlike fractions. So, these fractions are what? Like or unlike? Yes, since the denominators are same, these fractions are like fractions. So we can add directly. As in the case of comparing fractions, I told like fractions we can compare directly. That means only the numerators we have to check. Here also in the case of addition, first if it is not a like fraction, we have to convert it into a like fraction. The second step, in addition, we are adding only the numerators. The denominator remains same. That is the main point you have to keep in your mind. We are adding only the numerators. Here, what is it? 3 by 7 plus 2 by 7. I told it is already a like fraction. So, no need of converting. So, I can add it directly. Add it directly means only we are adding the numerators. Here what is the numerator? 3, and here what it is? 2. So 3 plus 2. The denominator I am writing as such, 7 itself. So the answer we are getting 3 plus 2, 5, and the denominator, same denominator. Never add the denominators, only add the numerators. One more example we will check. 12 by 25 plus 9 by 25. Here also it is a like fraction. So we can add it directly. So I told we'll add only the numerators. What are the numerators here? 12, 9. So 12 plus 9, denominator remain same. What is 12 plus 9? 21. Denominator 25. So what is the fraction? 21 by 25. Next example. 3 by 5 plus 2 by 7. Here is it a like fraction? By looking at the denominator, we can see that this is not a like fraction. This is an unlike fraction. So what is the first step I said? We have to convert this fraction into a like fraction. We have already discussed about how to convert by finding the LCM. Here 5 and 7, you know this is prime numbers. So directly you can multiply. What is 5 into 7? 35. So the LCM is 35. Now convert the denominators to 35. That means numerator also will be converted. Here 5 into 7 is 35. So you are multiplying the numerator also with 7. So 3 into 7, 21. 5 into 7, 35. The new fraction is 21 by 35. Next 2 by 7. 7 into 5 is 35. So we are multiplying the whole fraction with 5. 7 into 5, 35. 2 into 5, 10. So the new fraction is 10 by 35. Now I converted both the fractions into like fractions. What are the new fractions? 21 by 35 and 10 by 35. Now we can add. So for adding, what I told you, we will add only the numerators. No adding of denominators. So what are the numerators here? 21 and 10. So 21 plus 10. The denominator is 35 itself. So 21 plus 10 is 31. What is the denominator? 35. So we are getting the fraction 31 by 35. Next example. 4 plus 7 by 8. Here, what is the first one? 4. Is it a fraction? Now it is like a whole number, but we can convert this into a fraction. How?
Here we don't have a denominator part, isn't it? So I made that denominator part as 1. Is there any change for the value of that number? No, 4 by 1 means what? 4 itself. So if you are getting a number like this, how can you convert into fraction? Just write the denominator as 1. So 4 by 1 plus 7 by 8. Now we made both the numbers into fractions. Now here it is 1 and here it is 8. You know 1 is neither a prime nor a composite. So the LCM will be 1 into 8 itself. So LCM you got 1 into 8, 8. Now we have to convert the denominators into 8. Here already this fraction is having the denominator 8. So no need of converting that. So what we have to convert? This fraction only we need to convert. So 4 by 1 into 1 into what is 8? 8. So we are multiplying that fraction into 8. So numerator 4 into 8, 32. 1 into 8, 8. So 32 by 8. Here it is already 7 by 8. No need of any change. So I multiplied with 1 itself. So 7 by 8. Now we converted the given fraction into like fraction. What are they? 32 by 8 and 7 by 8. Now we can add. What is it? 32 plus 7. I said no adding of denominators. So 32 plus 7 by 8. What is 32 plus 7? 39 by 8. So the answer is 39 by 8. Next example. 2 2 by 3 plus 3 1 by 2. You know this is a mixed fraction, isn't it? So how can we add 2 mixed fraction? This is mixed fraction as well as it is unlike fraction. So 2 method you can follow for addition of mixed fraction. First method, you know you have studied how to convert a mixed fraction into improper fraction. So convert the given 2 mixed fractions into improper fraction. What is the first one here? 2, 2 by 3. How will you convert? I said we will multiply the whole number part with the denominator. Then with the product we will add the numerator. So 2 into 3, what you are getting? 2 into 3, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So the improper fraction is 8 by 3. Next 3 1 by 2. Again multiplying 3 into 2. What is 3 into 2? 6 plus 1, 7. So what is the fraction? 7 by 2. Now normal fraction you have studied, 8 by 3, 7 by 2. How we will you add? First we will convert it into like fraction. Here what are the denominators? 3 and 2. You know both are prime numbers. So the LCM will be 3 into 2, 6. So converting 8 by 3, this fraction, when we are converting we are getting 3 into 2 is 6. So numerator also we are multiplying 8 into 2. What is 8 into 2? 16. So denominator 6. So 16 by 6. Next 7 by 2. 2 into 3 is 6. So numerator also multiplying with 3. 7 into 3, 21. So what is the new fraction? 21 by 6. Now we converted it into an unlike fraction. So we can add it directly. 16 by 6 plus 21 by 6. I said we will add only the numerators. So 16 plus 21 is 37 by 6. This is one method. Now the other method means 2 2 by 3 plus 3 1 by 2 is the given fraction. First add the whole number part along. Here what is the whole number part? 2. Here what is the whole number part? 3. So what is 2 plus 3? 5. So first portion is over. We added the whole number part along. Next we have to add the fraction part. What is the fraction part? Here 2 by 3. Here 1 by 2. So adding that, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 2. This is a unlike fraction. So we have to convert this into like fraction. So multiply. That means finding the LCM. 3 into 2, 6. Now converting the denominators to 6. 2 by 3, 3 into what is 6? 2. So both the fraction you are multiplying with 2. 2 into 2, 4. 3 into 2, 6. So 2 by 3 we converted into 4 by 6. Next 1 by 2. 2 into what is 6? 3. So multiplying the whole fraction with 3. So 1 into 3, 3. 2 into 3, 6. So what is the new fraction? 3 by 6. Now we convert it to like fraction. 4 by 6 and 3 by 6. So we can add it. 4 by 6 plus 3 by 6. What it is? 7 by 6. So the fraction part also we added. Fraction part we got 7 by 6. And the whole number part we got 5. Now we have to add this both part. So 5 plus 7 by 6. A whole number part a fraction. We will get a mixed fraction. 5, 7 by 6. When we convert this into improper fraction, what is it? 5 into 6, what is 5 into 6? 30. Adding the product to the numerator, what is the numerator here? 7. So 30 plus 7, 37. Denominator same 6. Any method you can follow, but for your convenience, I'll say convert the given fraction to improper fraction and add. That will be the best option. So concluding today's class, we discussed today about addition. First we discussed addition of like fraction. Like fraction we can add directly. Next we discussed unlike fraction addition. For unlike fraction we have to convert the first unlike fraction to like fraction, then only we can add. Next mixed fraction. Mixed fraction in the case of addition, mixed fraction we can do it in two methods. Either by converting the given mixed fraction to improper fraction, and by converting to like fraction you can do in that method or by the other method. In any method, addition of fraction means only you are adding the numerators. No addition of denominators. The denominator is the common denominator and does not have any change. We are adding only the numerators. So that's all for today's class. Hope all of you understood the class. Copy down the notes. Attend the test paper given. Send the photo of your answers to the mentioned email ID. Meet you tomorrow in the next video. Thank you.